This video is one that I've been planning to do for a long time. We've had a lot of requests for it, and that is how to hook up the tow dolly and how to hook up the vehicle to the tow dolly. So let's get started. I'm gonna do this all in one take so that you can see the amount of time, the actual amount of time that it takes to do this. It's really pretty simple. And then once I'm done the entire thing, then we'll talk about the process, why you should or should not use a tow dolly. I'll give you some opinions on that, but let's get started. Dolly more here in Mexico than anywhere because the sights tend to be shorter, but I normally don't unhook it if I don't have to. So we just come up and it hooks up like a normal trailer. It goes on the ball, flip that over to lock that down, and then there's a pin that goes through to hold that to make sure that it stays on the ball. All right. Next, I like to hook up my safety brake. If the trailer was to break away, this thing will do a quick release on the brakes and stop the brakes. Then I can hook up my lights. I can't hook up my lights because they're hooked under the chains, so let's do the chains. These I crisscross, so the one on the right will hook up over here on the left, and the one on the left will hook up over on the right side. Pretty easy. And then your 4-pin plug here goes like this. And these 4 pins sometimes take a minute. Nope. Popped right in there pretty nicely. Then I'll swing the wheel up out of the way. And the trailer is hooked up. Pretty easy. Now we'll grab the car. Oh, no, I'm not gonna grab the car. First I wanna tilt this down. So you pick this, tilt it. Let the safety latch release. If you do not have one of these on your dolly, you've got a different type of latch, you should really look into that. Don't be telling me to hurry up, camera woman. Square to the dolly as possible. I open up my door. I've got 1 foot on the brake, 1 foot on the gas. You just roll up, watch your tire going on, and you'll feel it click in. Boom, you're in the dolly. Now I can put the car in park and turn the car off. I'll go back into the back and get the straps and finish up. Now, because I'm doing this in real time, it's a little tough because I'm going to adjust some cameras and things, but no need to get in a hurry. You just make sure your straps are ready to rock and roll. They're straight. There's no twists in them. You put on the hooks, and on the other side, I'll show you how to do that when I adjust the other, I'll adjust the other camera so that you can see that. And the basket goes up over the tire, like that. And then it goes down into this ratchet. And I put about a foot or so in there, and then ratchet that one down. On the other side, I'll show you on this camera as I'm doing this. Keep that sound on, Lori. Do the same thing. Just make sure your straps are straight.
Throw on the hooks. The hooks on the bar there.
Your dolly may be a little bit different, but they work mostly the same. So if your dolly's a little bit different, you might have to adjust a little bit. Make sure the basket is up over top. Then we're gonna come around to the front. And we're going to open this ratchet. Drop down. Ratchet that in. My lovely camera assistant there. So that's it. That is the dolly hooked up and the car installed. It's that simple. I don't have any brakes to hook up. I don't have any of that stuff. The car has already got the brakes on. So we actually take the keys out of the car, lock the car, windows up, done. That's it. And we'll talk about the rest of the tow dolly process here in just a second. All right, I don't know how long that took, but I know it probably wasn't more than 5 minutes. Like I said before, for the most part, I do not unhook the dolly if I don't have to. If I can back into a spot with the dolly on, I do that. So it's just a matter of rolling the car up onto the dolly like I did, strapping the tires down, and you're good to go. I would say in the 3 to 4 minute mark to get it hooked up. It's really pretty simple. Now, the other thing I will say is normally Lori drives the car. I just give her directions on how to come up so she doesn't have to look at the wheels. I put the wheels on in the spot that I want them to. She stops, I throw the baskets on, and we're good to go. So it actually goes a little bit quicker even with two people because we can have the straps out and all that kind of stuff, but I wanted to show you guys again in real time about all that. One of the other things that I would add to your dolly if you don't have it is the wheel that I showed you on the front. It's a simple bolt-on thing that bolts onto the tongue, and it allows you to move your dolly around very, very easily without having to pick up the tongue and hold the tongue in the air. You can literally just roll the dolly around on the ground. The other thing that I installed is there used to be a pin that went underneath our dolly, and I had to put that pin in and put a safety pin in it, and it was a complete pain in the ass. It would actually, sometimes when you hit a dip in the road, it would dip down, pop the safety pin out, and then that pin would be gone. We wouldn't notice that until we were in the next town, and then we could hear the tow dolly scrape in the back. I decided I needed a better way to do that, so I put this, what I call an auto tilt mechanism. I bought it at a trailer supply store. I put it on the front, and now it is literally so easy to take the car on and off with that device, and it doesn't disconnect when we're going down the road, so that works really good. That's it. That's how to hook up a tow dolly, and that is how to add your car to the tow dolly. One more thing I want to add. Why would you use a tow dolly? Here's the scoop on tow dollies. If you already have a front wheel drive car like we had when we started, it was easier. The tow dolly, I think, was $1,000, $1,200, camera woman.
The dolly?
Yeah, $1,200.
It was, yeah, $1,500, I think.
After we bought the second one, which I won't get into that right now, but $1,200. So fairly inexpensive compared to adding your base plate and your tow kits to the vehicle. So if you already have a two-wheel drive car, it makes it totally easy. I would also say if you have a really short coach, makes it easy to park still when you have the tow dolly. If you have a really long coach, I would recommend going four down. It's a pain in the ass to find a spot to put this if you can't fit it into campgrounds. Having that as an extra component to have to store somewhere, a little bit of a pain in the ass. For me, it's not a big deal. Like I said, I don't unhook it, so I don't really care. If you've got a four-wheel drive vehicle, you're gonna have to tow it four down or four up. I would say to tow that four down. Again, not necessary for a tow dolly. If you tow four down though, now you gotta deal with the brake systems and all that kind of stuff. So that's the tow dolly. You have to decide for yourself whether it's tow dolly for you or whether it's four down for you. There's good and bad in all of them. That's my take on the tow dolly, and who knows in the future, if we wind up with a four-wheel drive, then we're gonna have to wind up going four down, and then Kevin's gonna laugh at me. And so as you can see by that video, hooking up the tow dolly to the RV and putting a vehicle on the tow dolly, not all that difficult. And as you can see here in this particular campground, we just left the tow dolly hooked up, backed right into the spot. So it's not that much that you have to deal with the next time around. So if this is your first time here, it'd be awesome if you hung out with us a little bit, got to know us, maybe learned a thing or two if you're a newbie, and that means you have to hit that subscribe button. It'd be equally as cool if you liked the video, and we'll see you again in the next one. Bye now.